Now, exercise 9.1, question number 4. The angle of elevation of the top of a tower from a point on the ground, which is 30 meters away from the foot of the tower, is 30 degrees. Find the height of the tower. Find the height of the tower. So, in the question, it is given that angle of elevation of the top of a tower from a point on the ground which is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower is 30 degree. And we have to find height of the tower. In this question also figure is not given. So we should draw the figure first. According to the question, we have to draw the figure first. So this is the tower. We represent the tower by the vertical line. Okay, this is the tower. This is the top of the tower. Then we can give the name it as A, B. Then according to the question, it is given that from the point on the ground. So this is the ground level. So from the point on the ground, the angle of elevation of the top. So this is the angle of elevation of the top. Okay, so this is given as 30 degrees. This is the point on the ground. This is the top of the tower. So the angle of elevation of the top of the tower from the point on the ground is given as 30 degree. So this vertical tower and the ground level become 90 degree. Okay. Then according to the question, we have to find the height of the tower. Then it is given that the distance between the foot and the point from where the elevation, angle of elevation of the tower taken, that distance is given as 30 meter. Foot and this point, this distance is given as 30 meter. So here we have to find H. So about this 30 degree, this is the opposite side. And this is adjacent. So opposite and adjacent, that relation we should take. Okay. So opposite by adjacent. What is the relation opposite by adjacent? It is tan theta. So opposite is H. Adjacent is 30. This is equal tan 30. So what is the value of tan 30? That is 1 by root 3. 1 by root 3. So, H by 30 equal 1 by root 3. So, H equal 30 by root 3. Transpose this 30 to here. Then we should rationalize that. For that, we should multiply both the numerator and denominator by root 3. So, we will get 30 root 3 by root 3 into root 3 is 3. So, we will get it as 10 root 3. So, height of the tower is 10 root 3 meter. 10 root 3 meter. If you want to multiply that by the value of root 3, 1.732, that you can do. Otherwise, you can write this itself. Okay. So, here the height of the tower is 10 root 3 meter. Now, exercise 9.1, question number 5. A kite is flying at a height of 60 meter above the ground. The string attached to the kite is temporarily tied to a point on the ground. The inclination of the string with the ground is 60 degree. Find the length of the string. Assuming that there is no slack in the string. That we should assume. Okay. So according to the question, it is given that there is a kite which is flying at a height of 60 meter above the ground, and the inclination of the string with the ground is 60 degree. Then here we have to find the length of the string. In this question also figure is not given, so we should draw it first. According to the question, this is the kite which is flying at the height 60 meter from the ground. So, this is the vertical distance between the ground and the kite. And it is already given that angle of inclination of the string with the ground. So this is the string. This is the string. Then the angle of inclination of the string with the ground is given as 60 degree. Then we have to find the length of the string, that is L, we have to find. Okay, so this is the triangle ABC. This vertical height and the ground become 90 degree. So from this figure we have to find the hypotenuse. It is given that opposite of this angle 60 degree. So hypotenuse we have to find, opposite is given. So we can take the trigonometric ratio opposite by hypotenuse, that is equal sine theta. So opposite is, here it is 60, hypotenuse is L, sine theta is sine 60. You already know that the value of sine 60 as root 3 by 2. So 60 by L equal root 3 by 2. So L root 3 equal 60 into 2. Just transposing them. Then 120 by root 3 is equal L. Then here we have to rationalize. So L equal, L length of the string L equal 120 into root 3 by root 3 into root 3. Multiply by root 3, both the numerator and denominator. So we got 120 root 3 by 3. 120 and 3 we can cut, then what we will get? 40. So the answer is length of the string L equal 40 root 3 meter. L equal 40 root 3 meter. Okay. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.